All right, now it's time to learn how to make a voiceover file, an audio file, from a camera recording that we used in class with the microphones. You could do this with just a simple smartphone and record the audio only with a voice recorder and then edit those files, but we use camcorders with microphones. All right, so first thing you need to do is make your Prezi VO folder. If you've never made a folder before, like I have here, you right-click, New Folder. Name it Prezi VO. Now, after you've recorded all of your voiceovers, you take the files from your camera and you transfer them into this folder. We're also going to connect Premiere to this folder, the first time you've used Premiere. So here's how you set Premiere up each time you start a brand new project file. You'll go to your Start button and you'll look for Adobe Premiere. And when you find it in the Programs folder, give it a second to open and it'll appear like this. All right, so there are recent projects here. You won't have any if you've never used Premiere before, so this will be empty. We have Open Project and New Project. Click on New Project. Now quickly check to see that the capture is HDV, not DV. Make sure you switch it to HDV if it is not. Next is the location of where all the Premiere files are going to go. Right now, mine are set for a folder I'm not using. This is a different folder. So you need to click Browse to find the folder you just created for your Prezi VO. Go into my desktop looking for Prezi VO. And I found it. So connect to that folder. And once you've connected to the folder, your path will now read your account desktop Prezi VO. I'm going to name the file Prezi VO as well, in case we need to open it again later and continue editing. Now hit OK. A second window comes up that asks us to pick our video quality style. What I'm going to ask you to do is to choose HDV 1080p 30, and that'll create a high def television style 1080p file for you. If we were filming with a different type of camera, we might choose a different setting, but you want to be in the HDV folder. You click this triangle. It might have started you here in the DVNTSC folder. Don't use that. Go to HDV 1080p 30. That's for 30 frames a second. Video is nothing more than 30 pictures taken every second. Okay. So once you've hit OK, we move back into Premiere itself now. It takes a second for it to pop up. There we are. So what we're going to do is we're going to bring in our files so that we can begin to edit them. A few ways you can import files into the project panel, which is right here, it's highlighted. There's also an effects controls panel we'll talk about when we do video lessons. There's a sequence panel here for the program. It's the actual monitor, the TV screen you'll see the editing in. Down here in the bottom is the timeline where most of the editing takes place, along with an effects panel area to grab transitions and effects. There's also a toolbar over here that's very useful. We'll end up using a couple tools. All right, so you can say to import files here, File, Import. That's one way. Hitting Control I is another. Another is to right click in an empty area of this project panel, and you can do an import. Or you could simply double click in the project bin and you'll have the import. Navigate to your folder for the Prezi VO to find your files. Open it up, and I'm going to shift click. Click on the first one, go to the last one, hit shift, and click again, and that selects all of the files, and hit open. That'll transfer them all into the project panel. Now, once they're in here, it might be pretty simple when it's a handful of files, but a lot of Premiere projects, you'll have, 70, 100, 200 files inside of this project panel. And it becomes very difficult to work with if you don't organize your work. So to get into that habit, I'm going to ask you to make a folder, which they call a bin in Premiere. One way is to open your project panel window a little wider, in case you can't see it, and you'll notice that there's a folder button. Another way is to right-click New Bin. So we make the bin, name it VOs, and we're going to drag by selecting them all. I'll use my mouse to lasso them. You can also use the shift click method. Click and drag them into this folder. Now they're in the folder. If I hit the triangle next to the folder, it will open and close and show me the voiceover files. Now there's quite a few of them here, but we're going to essentially just edit one in this video to show you how to do it. You'll need to edit all 12 of yours for your Prezi project. All right, I'm going to click on that video and hold the mouse down and drag it into the timeline. Drag it into the first tracks, video one and audio one. You could do it in two, but it's easier to work in one. If this window pops up, say yes, change sequence settings, because Premiere recognizes a slightly different file type than you were working with. All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to learn to zoom in. The timeline itself reads time from zero onward. The end of the scroll bar, which is just a scroll bar, has a box, and the box is the zoom controller. If you click and pull it to the left, you'll zoom in. It goes way in on time. If you go to the right, it'll zoom out. So now you're seeing we're seeing more time here. 32 seconds, a minute four, 1:36. If I zoom in, because we have such a small clip, I can work on it better. So we're going to zoom in so that I see things in seconds. 1 second, 2 second, 3 second. You adjust this until you see that. All right, now that we're zoomed in, we need to begin to edit this clip to make the voiceover itself. I'm using a file from a project I did for a client this past summer, helping them make commercials, and he voiced over some of his products. So I'm going to use this as the voiceover sample. What you need to do is throw out the video first. To do that, simply right-click on the video itself and click on Unlink. That takes the video away from the audio. So now that the video is highlighted, you can hit the delete key on your keyboard, or you could right click and go to clear. It takes the video out and leaving us just with audio. Now we want to make this audio sound good, so we need to be able to fade it in and fade it out, also trim it to make it work. What we're going to do now is we're going to actually open this triangle for the audio bar that our voiceover is in, so we can see the audio graphically. This shows you everything that you can see. If I hit play, you'll hear what we have so far on this voiceover.
3, 2.
Our large box is 18 by 18 by 24 inches and is used for light items.
Okay.
All right, so as you can tell, the voiceover section is in here. And we need to clean away my voice counting here and this audio voice here. It's pretty easy to cut things away in Premiere from the ends. All you need to do is move your mouse to the beginning or end of a clip to create a red bracket. There's my red bracket when I move it there. So I'm going to click and drag off that part of the file to just before the voiceover starts. I'm going to go to the back of the file and do the same. Turn my mouse into a red bracket. Again, it does it automatically if you just put your mouse at the end of the file. And I'm going to trim it backwards. Now I've got this audio file that's been trimmed. Anything in the beginning and end is gone, just the important information in the middle is still here. Click at the top of the file and drag it to the home or zero location on the timeline. Now let's check and see how it sounds.
Our large box is 18 by 18 by 24 inches and is used for light items.
All right, so there is the file itself. Now, it makes noise at the end abruptly. When the file is done, it goes from sound of microphone air to nothing. So we're going to fade that off, both the beginning and the end. To do so, in your effects panel, it's right over here in this area. If you don't see this panel, simply go to Window and find the name of the panel you're looking for. Right now, Effects, which is right here. Go to the Audio Transitions folder, which allows us to do a simple fade in and fade out. Hit the triangle. Go to the crossfade folder, hit the triangle. Constant power is the normal, typical fade-in for Premiere, and it's already highlighted. So click on the icon and drag it to the very end of the clip and let it go. Do the same at the back of the clip. Go to the back of the clip, touch it, and let it go. Now the fades are added so that it comes in and out a little more cleanly. One thing I want to bring up is that this is a 1 second fade, 1 second in time on the 6 second clip. At 1 second, it is fading in, but it's still fading in as we begin talking. Same with the ending. It begins fading out before the talking is over. I oftentimes like to not interrupt the talking, and so I'll add a little more clip in so that the fade is over with right about where we start talking. And I'll do the same at the back so that we are done talking before it begins to fade out. Now I'm going to drag this back to home, making sure that I'm at the home marker at the beginning. My clip is now fully edited and trimmed. We're going to export it so that we can upload it to our Prezi. Prezi only accepts the MP3 files at this point, so we want to make sure we're making an MP3 file. One other thing to take care of, notice is that before you export, check out this bar right here. It's the work area bar. If it is too far across, farther than your clip, it'll create a lot of extra file where there's no sound. If it's too short, it'll cut everything off from the other side of the area of the work area bar. You want to make sure you want to make sure it goes right to the end of your file. It should clip right there. Now this is the entire file. So let's export it so it's ready for Prezi. To export this file, simply go to File, Export, Media. Now if this isn't highlighted, that's because you clicked away from your timeline panel and highlighted a different panel. So make sure you are clicking in the panel itself and that it's highlighted so that when you have File, Export, Media is now highlighted and you can export your files. A couple of things to check before you export. The format is the file type. Right now it's set to AVI, which is a large video format. We're going to change it to MP3. Hit the drop down and find MP3 in the middle. Select MP3. Now the preset is the quality setting. MP3 128 kilobytes per second is pretty good, but there are higher ones, and I'm going to go with the highest setting we have for the highest quality audio. All right, now the last thing you need to do is output name. We need to name the file and have it saved back into our folder so that we can use it for the Prezi upload. I'm going to pretend that this is the intro clip where you say, hello, welcome to my Prezi, and name the authors of the Prezi. So I'll name this intro. I'll click. I'll navigate to my Prezi VO folder. Make sure you're going to that folder with the file so it's easier to find. Open. And now save the file. And I'm going to call this Prezi VO, Prezi Intro VO, which will be the first VO. And we'll hit save. At this point, we're ready to export the file. It has an MP3 style with a high quality recording, along with a name and location. You just click export, and within seconds, the file is made. So now, first file is done. You will click on and delete this file to move on to your second file to do the same thing to. And remember, when you do this, this bar doesn't always adjust. So you want to make sure your work area bar covers your audio and stays that way as you finish. Now we can find out if the file really worked. Remember, you'll do all of your voiceovers this way, one export after another, naming them whatever they're called to put them on your Prezi. I'm going to minimize Premiere for a second. I'm going to go to the Prezi VO folder and open it. And I can see my original files, but now here is a MP3 file for the voiceover. I'll double click on it to make sure it sounds good.
Our large box is 18 by 18 by 24 inches and is used for light items.
Clean. The back and front sound smooth, and it has been trimmed off of any unwanted sounds. So that's it. Now all of these files, as you make all of your voiceover files, would be the ones you'll use to upload to whatever location stop on your Prezi that you want them to be on. All right, thanks. I hope that works out for you, and good luck on finishing up your project.